visiting the Marshfield Agricultural Research Station. We're visiting today with Nancy Esser, superintendent of the station, University of Wisconsin in the College of Agricultural and Life Sciences, Madison, Wisconsin, and I'm C.V. Kenyon. Nancy, give us a little introduction to the type of work done here at the Marshfield Station.
C.V., the station is approximately 1,400 acres set between two sites. Our original South Station is comprised of offices, laboratories, and an auditorium. The new site has grown substantially in the last 10 years. We broke ground back in 2003. Since that time, in 2011, we acquired a milking herd. We're at 660 animals strong. The kind of work that is taking place here at the station ranges from soil-based research, agronomy, several agronomy trials that some are new, some are in their third or fourth year. And our specialty, this site is a site among no others. This is a site in which we are the grower for the state herd of heifers, and it is a premier institution for heifer-based research. We have 550 heifers on site in which multiple scientists use this herd to conduct their research.
Well, Nancy, tell us a little bit about the heifers. What kind of work goes on with them?
We're conducting intake trials with the heifers using gammagrass. There's been extensive limit feeding studies. There's been feeding trials. We're using a eastern gammagrass. It's a perennial grass that's typically grown in the southern part of the United States. That has been introduced to northern climates. It's been integrated into feeding trials with our heifers. There's been a couple years worth of research on that. We also have been the site of extensive limit feeding. Limit feeding is reducing the amount of forage in a heifer's diet, offsetting it with concentrates to attain the nutrients the animal needs, the calories, protein that the animal needs, and allowing that animal to attain industry growth at calving that the industry expects. So by restrict feeding these animals or limit feeding, we're able to cut back on one of the most expensive commodities that are fed to the animals, that being forage, and still the animals are conditioned where we need them. They excrete less manure, and we can get them where we want them to be at calving.
And Nancy, how does this work benefit the agricultural community?
These are studies in which our scientists are taking into the communities. They are sharing during webinars. They're sharing with Hordes Dairymen, Popular Farm Press. It's also something that consultants are learning, and they're able to take out into the farms and share with their constituents.
What's the most interesting part of your job?
The most interesting part of my job, I would have to say, is a new research trial. I get very excited when I am presented with a protocol, and I very much enjoy setting them up, talking to staff about what things are going to happen on that trial, what are the needs of the trial, and what are the needs that population of animals are going to be used, what unique pieces of information are going to be extracted from these animals.
Nancy, can you give us an example of some of the research being done here?
We are in the process of analyzing four different bedding substrates used in our barn. Bedding substrates meaning different types of beddings that are used under the cows. What we're looking at is, are these appropriate beddings to use under animals?
We've been visiting with Nancy Esser, superintendent at the Marshfield Agricultural Research Station, University of Wisconsin in the College of Agricultural and Life Sciences, Madison, Wisconsin, and I'm C.V. Kenyon.